Cisplatin is one of the medication that belongs to anti-cancer agents. Chemically, this drug is a platinum compound. Cisplatin can act on the DNA as an alkylating agent, and it produces cross-linking between the DNA strands, which inhibits DNA replication. Within the name of cisplatin, we can observe the suffix platin, which indicates it is a platinum compound. We have few of the other drugs in this category like carboplatin, oxaliplatin, nedaplatin, and lobaplatin. Among these platinum compounds, cisplatin is the first generation compound that was developed as an anti-cancer agent. This drug is given by IV infusion for treating various types of cancers. The primary use of cisplatin is in the treatment of ovarian cancer in the woman, and it can also be used to treat testicular cancer in the men. It can also be used for treating bladder cancer, as well as an off-label purpose, it can be used for treating many type of cancers. This medication can be used either alone or in combination with other anti-cancer agents. However, chemotherapy involves so many types of medications, and cisplatin is one of the medications that is widely used in many of the dosage regimens. However, many of the anti-cancer agents are toxic in nature, including cisplatin. Therefore, cisplatin can affect the various organs in the body, including kidney, and it can also affect the vision. It also has few effects on hearing. All these are very essential to know before using cisplatin. Serious side effects produced by cisplatin depends on the number of cycles for which it is going to be used and what are the coexisting risk factors. So today in this video, we are going to discuss the important side effects of cisplatin and how they are managed. First of all, nausea and vomiting. Cisplatin is highly toxic, just like many of the anti-cancer agents. This compound acts as emetogenic that induces nausea and vomiting. When it is going to be administered, it can stimulate chemoreceptor trigger zone in the brain, which induces emesis. Therefore, pre-treatment with anti-emetic agents is highly essential before using cisplatin. Without pre-treatment with anti-emetic agents, a severe nausea and vomiting can be observed with administration of cisplatin. Therefore, pre-treatment with anti-emetic agents is highly essential. Nausea and vomiting can be observed within 1 to 4 hours of administration of cisplatin. Since this drug is given by IV infusion, we can observe immediate side effects produced by this medication. However, this effect can be continued up to few days, and it may lead to the peak levels and produce a severe nausea and vomiting after 48 to 72 hours after administration. In a few people, this nausea and vomiting can also be observed up to 1 week. Therefore, anti-emetic treatment should be continued even after stopping the dose of cisplatin. If required, additional anti-emetics may be added in order to control nausea and vomiting. Generally, if you have the anti-emetics like ondansetron can be given to control nausea and vomiting produced by cisplatin. Second important side effect is the nephrotoxicity. Use of cisplatin can develop one of the condition acute renal failure. As cisplatin is highly toxic, it can produce renal failure within a short period. And this effect is more pronounced with increase in the dose of the cisplatin. Because of more accumulation of the drug with repeated uses, acute renal failure may be more pronounced with increased number of cycles of administration. In a few people, the symptoms of acute renal failure may be developed within 5 days of treatment. Therefore, it is highly essential to monitor the symptoms of nephrotoxicity with use of cisplatin. In a few people, the symptoms of nephrotoxicity are more developed in the second week of the treatment, and we can observe elevated levels of blood parameters like increased serum creatinine, increased blood urea nitrogen, and elevated levels of serum potassium. All these elevated levels indicate a dysfunction in the renal system. In order to minimize nephrotoxicity, few of the precautions should be taken before using cisplatin. Adequate hydration should be maintained before the treatment, and the urine output should be normal 24 hours before initiation of treatment. Similarly, before starting the therapy, few of the blood parameters should be checked like creatinine clearance, serum creatinine levels, as well as blood urea nitrogen and serum electrolytes. If patient is having normal values of these parameters, then cisplatin can be used. But in case of any abnormal values, use of cisplatin should be avoided. Not only before initiation of therapy, these blood parameters should be checked during the therapy in order to assess the renal functionality. In a few people, magnesium levels may be reduced with use of cisplatin, which can be maintained by administration of magnesium supplements. In case of significant reduction of creatinine clearance and elevation of serum creatinine levels with use of cisplatin is observed, then the dose of cisplatin should be reduced. In such people, combination therapy is more suggested in order to avoid the direct toxic effects of cisplatin. Another important side effect is the peripheral neuropathy. Cisplatin can also affect the function of neurons. A high dose of cisplatin can produce damage to the neurons, and it can develop one of the condition peripheral neuropathy. This peripheral neuropathy can be observed with a single dose of cisplatin, and the severity of this condition can be increased with repeated usage of cisplatin. Because of this peripheral neuropathy, people may have paresthesias, loss of sensation, particularly the loss of awareness of movements can be observed, and it also produces loss of muscle reflexes, which impairs muscle movement and coordination. It also produces loss of vibratory sensation in the hands. All this may increase numbness, pinning sensation, stinging and burning in the hands and feet. The risk of peripheral neuropathy is more observed in the elders. It can also be increased with coexisting conditions like diabetes. One of the important point is that this peripheral neuropathy is irreversible in nature. So once it is going to be developed, it cannot be restored easily. Therefore, a neurological examination should be done during the therapy of cisplatin to check any development of peripheral neuropathy. Another important side effect is the ototoxicity. Another important effect of cisplatin is on the vestibular system, and it can produce a condition of tinnitus, a buzzing noise in the ears. With increased dose, cisplatin can also produce some hearing loss, which impairs the hearing of normal conversations. And this effect of cisplatin is cumulative in nature. The hearing loss is more pronounced with repeated usage of this medication. This ototoxicity is observed more in the children, particularly with age group less than 5 years. So in such pediatric patients, use of cisplatin is not recommended. During the use of cisplatin, audiometric testing should be done in order to check any loss of hearing and development of tinnitus in the people. What are the other side effects? Cisplatin can also affect the eye, and it can produce a state of blurred vision. And people may have an altered perception of colors with use of cisplatin. At higher doses, this drug can also increase the blindness in the people. Being an anti-cancer agent, cisplatin can produce the bone marrow depression, which results in the decreased neutrophil count that may increase the risk of infections. So with use of cisplatin, a development of fever and inflammation may indicate the infection due to bone marrow depression. So in such people, cisplatin should be carefully used, because with repeated uses, the risk of infection is more elevated. Cisplatin can also produce hypersensitive reactions in a few people. Due to this action, it can increase the facial swelling, difficulty breathing, redness and rashes on the skin. If any hypersensitive reaction is developed towards cisplatin, it should not be readministered to avoid fatal allergic reactions. So these are the important and serious side effects of cisplatin. Being an anti-cancer agent and a toxic substance, cisplatin can produce very serious side effects. However, by taking few precautions and adjusting the dose properly, these side effects can be minimized. So that's all about the side effects of cisplatin. I hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.